the other week, we went to see his cousin-in-law in Barcelona. Right? No, not
Milan.
Barcelona. Milan. In Milan. Those are different cities? Different countries. Anyway, we went to Milan in Italy, and we went to our room, and there was this, it was basically two beds pushed together to make one humongo bed. I grew up in a small house with a big brother, so it doesn't bother me, you know? And he was like, oh, there's one bed, oh God, there's one bed, how do you feel about this? Relax, I'm sleeping where you used to be.
What's your favorite indoor hobby?
The perfect segue for Rob's comment is very well. Tell the young man about your favorite indoor hobby, Rob. Right? We've been trying to force grown men to share a bed with you. It starts there. No. Tell your version, Rob.
It's a great question. I like playing chess and checkers. Arm wrestling.
Not helping you.
Cards, I love cards. And I think grown people feel like little boys and camp together and I camp together and we're like, we're camping together. Anyway, it's great. This is great fodder for your story. Just let me finish real quick. He called and had our room changed to two beds, and I was like, okay.
You realize you're just making stuff up. I get this. I get we do improv on stage here, but let's stick to the facts.
All right.
The facts are, we went to Milan to see my brother-in-law, my cousin-in-law. They each had a room, and then Rob and I were sharing one. My brother-in-law got the room with two beds. We got the room with one bed. So I didn't go, in the wilderness, there's only one bed, I'm cool with that.
I sat down and I went, oh my God, this is beautiful. And he's going,
I said, Michael, you have the room with two beds. Yes. We're going to switch rooms with you. And suddenly, little Shannon offended over here is like, what? You can just share a bed. I don't know why you're acting like this.
That's not bad me. You know, not how I do.
And I said, Rob, across the hall is the room with the two beds and the one guy, and then we're the two guys and the one bed, all together as a group. Why don't we just go over there to the two-bedroom, he'll walk over to the one-bedroom and prove problem solved. And meanwhile, Robbie's going like, you're acting so strange. I have a brother, and I have all these guy friends, and we always all share beds together. And I'm going, I'm not sure how I am being the weird one here. And I turn to my brother-in-law, cousin-in-law, who's behind us, kind of watching us spat. And I'm like,
he's like a football player.
I don't know.
What's with the weird little guy?
And they're like, what else? And to this day, you still find it offensive. And I am fascinated that you find it offensive because there was a room with two beds across the hall. Not that I won't share a bed with you, but I can sleep in my own bed across the hall. I don't understand your
bed. And the room by the way, it was the same thing, except the beds were just...
Yeah, the same thing, except the beds weren't attached to each other. The beds were separate.
Like this much?
I'm not the odd one here.
We could have...
Or you could walk across the hall.
I was putting my clothes in the drawer. You're only there for one night.
You're already hanging up your dresses. Trust me. A little piece of work, that dress. Unbelievable. Anyway, that's Rob's favorite indoor hobby. I'll leave you over there.
I stand by it.